everybody. I'm Corinne Blackstone, and welcome to my craft room. I'm so happy to have you here today, and before we get started, be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. Today's video is a question I see time and time again in Facebook groups, or people ask me in my video comments, so I'm going to show you how to upload handwriting. So I did a couple different examples here for you. One is one that obviously I wrote myself, and then one is one that I'm going to pull from a greeting card. I'm going to show you a couple options on ways to upload these, how to make sure they come out really well, and ways to remove the background, and which one works better. So let's go ahead and get started. If you have the option to have somebody write something for you to put onto vinyl or to whatever you want using your Cricut, I would highly recommend using a Sharpie, and I want you to use a thicker Sharpie for this. It's gonna give you a little bit bolder line, a little bit easier to cut. So I'm just gonna write a quick little message on this scrap piece of cardstock. You don't need to use anything great. I would recommend using white paper. So I'm just gonna use my own handwriting, and I'm just gonna write a little message on here. Use my name, and that is all. Nothing fancy. We'll put a little heart. If you don't have this option, I will also show you a way to do that as well, using some handwriting that I have from someone else. But if you have the option for somebody to write something down, highly recommend doing it like this. It's going to be a lot easier for your Cricut to recognize. You're not going to have to go through nearly as much struggle. So let's go ahead, and I'm going to show you how to upload both of these into your Cricut, and then we'll cut them both so you can kind of see the difference. Now, one option is you can use your phone and simply just take a photo of the design. But what I want you to make sure is that you don't have a big shadow on it. Like, you can see I'm getting a big shadow. So when I take the picture, it's got a big shadow on it, and we don't want that. So I want you to try to take the photo as evenly up as you can. So you want to be as straight over it as you can, but without a shadow. Now, I'm going to have a shadow in here because I have overhead lighting no matter what I do. So if that's going to happen to you, what you can do is just try to make sure that the shadow is fully over the writing. So like how I have it here, that shadow is completely over the writing. Then I want you to get pretty close to it. I want you to fill probably as much of the screen as you can, and then you can just simply take a photo. Now, I'm going to just double check it and make sure it looks good. I think it's good enough, but I could always improve. So I'm just going to take one more just to make sure that everything looks good. Yep, that looks good. So when we go to do this, we'll actually crop this a little bit before we remove the background. And I'm going to show you a couple ways to remove the background. Now, again, I'm going to show you how to do this another way using someone else's handwriting that maybe you don't have access to anymore, whether it's someone has passed on and you want to use their writing, or it's somebody who lives far away or whatever it may be. So I'm going to show you an option for that as well. It's very similar, but this is definitely the best option if you can get that handwriting. Now, the cool thing is, if you have a scanner, this is super easy. But what we want to do is, I'm going to use a scanner. So I've got some things that I do need to change. I don't have to change anything up here. Everything's fine. But I want to change my image format, and I'm just going to change it over to a PNG. And then I can rename it if I want to once we're ready to save. But all I'm going to do is click scan, and it's going to go ahead and scan that document on my scanner. Now, if you don't have a scanner, you can, of course, use that picture that you took on your phone. I just wanted to show you the scanner is definitely an option. Then all I want to do is click save, and I'm going to open it up so that you can see it. So this is our PNG version of the design. Now, it's backwards, it's upside down because of the way I had to put it in the scanner, because I was using a 12 by 12 sheet of cardstock. That's okay, no big deal. All I have to do from here is drag it and drop it over into Design Space. I'm going to choose complex and click continue. Now, before I do anything else, I am going to crop this because I have this line right here that I don't want it to catch when I go ahead to remove the background. So I'm just going to kind of make that smaller. I cut off the heart a little bit. That's okay. If that happens, no biggie. We'll just try again and not cut off the heart. There we go. That's much better. Now, once I've done that, I can go back over to this area. Now, if you don't have Cricut access, I'll show you that in a second. But what we can do is just use the remove background option. And if I preview it, you'll see that it's pretty good, right? So if you don't have that option, what you can do is use the select tool, and you can actually just click on your background, but you'll want to make sure that you get in between all of your letters. So don't forget that step. That's a really important step. But now I'm going to show you what the preview image looks like, and it looks basically the same, so we should be good to go. Go ahead and click apply and continue, and then you want to save it over here as a cut image. You'll notice that it looks kind of fat and chunky compared to the print then cut. The only reason is because Cricut is actually showing you the line that it's going to cut around, so it actually makes it look thicker than it is, but it's not. Click upload, and then we'll add this to our canvas. Now, like I said, it is upside down. Don't worry about it. It's totally fine. You can flip it over here on your canvas if you want to. So I'll just turn it around so you can see it. Now, I do have a little like black dot that it picked up. It could have been from my pen. If I just want to get rid of that, I can just simply go to contour and I can remove that little dot. Now let's say, oh, maybe we don't want to cut out the heart part that I drew. You can get rid of that as well. And obviously I totally didn't get rid of the heart, or the dot. So let me go back and try to click on that little dot and see if we can get rid of it. There we go. So you can kind of change it up using a contour. Now let's make it kind of big, and I'm going to change the color just so you can see it when we click make it, what it's going to look like. Now it's going to ask me if I want to save my project. I'll skip that for now. It's no big deal. But now you can see it's upside down again, but that's just a Cricut thing. You can just turn it on your mat if you want it the right way, or you can just cut it upside down. It really doesn't matter as long as it's cut. But you can see here, you've got my handwriting right there. Now I'm going to show you some handwriting from somebody else, so that way you can see how you can do it if you don't have somebody that's here to write the information out for you. I'm also going to show you a way that works sometimes a little bit better with that handwriting, because sometimes that's a little bit thinner, or maybe it's not as well done. Maybe they wrote it with a ballpoint pen. So I'll show you how to kind of correct that a little bit better than using Design Space. Now for this one with the signature on a greeting card, I'm gonna use remove.bg, which is a background remover. So what I'm gonna do is go to upload image, and I'm gonna choose the image that I just scanned into my computer. And it's going to take a second, but then it will remove the background. Now, I want to just preface this with, this is not always perfect. So you're going to have to play with it and just see what works best for the signature that you have, whether using Design Space, whether scanning, whether taking a picture. It just sort of depends on which one. Now, what's kind of cool about this is I can use this erase feature to kind of get rid of like certain things, like that line from where the card was. And I can also get rid of all this greeting part that I don't need, but I want to make sure to keep the signature part. So I'm just going to kind of get rid of this extra junk, and that should be fine for Design Space. So I'm going to click done. And then what I want to do is I'm going to click download. And I'm going to save this into my folder, and I will save it over into my Cricut folder, into my four videos. That way I kind of know what it is. And I'm just going to title it Judy, because that's who signed it. Just an FYI, the person who signed this is still alive. So over in Design Space, what we'll do is we'll choose upload, and then we're going to upload that image that we just made. So I'm going to click upload image, then choose browse. And I can find that image really quickly. Then all I need to do is choose complex, click continue, and then we're gonna leave it as is. Now it looks really hard to see right here. Don't worry, it's fine. It's just because that image was kind of big. But now we wanna save it as the cut image and click upload. Then I'm gonna select this design and add this to the canvas, and we'll see how it looks. Now you notice that it looks smaller now. I'm gonna go ahead and make it bigger so that you can see it. But you can see kind of how bad it looks. It's not great. So with something like this, when that happens, it's hard to see it on remove.bg to see what it looks like. This looks nothing like the signature that we scanned. So I'm going to show you what happens if we use the Cricut to do it. So I'm going to click upload. I'm going to choose browse, and then I'm going to choose the one that we just did. So that was this one here. Then I'm going to choose complex and click continue. Now I'm gonna crop this again, just because it's just so much easier to just work with it if it's smaller. And then again, I just wanna remove the background. So I click on the little box with the pencil, and I wanna make sure I have select chosen. And then in this case, I'm just gonna click on the actual background to remove it. And then you want to make sure you get in between any of the letters that you can. Now there are some small spots, so you can go through and kind of really click on them. If you need to get closer, just use the little zoom option, because I can see
I might need to get in between the D here, which is pretty small space. So I'm just going to give this a couple of clicks here. The D may not come out great, but it should be all right. And I'm just going to kind of look through and just see if there's anywhere else that might need removed. I'm probably going to get rid of this anyways, so I'm not really worried about it. But I think everything else should be fine. Oh, there's a little loop right here I missed. Now I'm going to click apply and continue. And I'm going to save this version. Oh, but I see I missed between the A. Oh, shoot. So I'm going to go back. And I just want to click in between the A. So again, what stinks about this, though, is that it does bring it back to the way you had it. So it can be really frustrating to do this with the Cricut. It's one of the reasons I don't love using the Cricut for this. But once you kind of go through and remove all of the pieces and not forget pieces like I did, let me go ahead and go through and get all those pieces. And then what we said we had to get between the D over here. We gotta click a couple times for the D because it's a little tight in there. And then I want to get that one. And then I just want to make sure. Okay, now that we've done it correctly, we can click apply and continue. That looks much better. So now what I'm going to do is select this and click upload. And this one here is the one we're going to use. But you can see the difference, just how much difference it made using a different program. So don't think just because it didn't come out perfect the first time that it's not going to work, because you just need to give it a little bit of time. Now, remember I said that I wanted to not have this part right here? There's a couple ways to get rid of it, but I'm just going to use contour to get rid of it because I don't want it there. I'm just going to click on the pieces and parts of it to get rid of it. And that way now all we have is the Love Aunt Judy part. Now this should cut pretty well on vinyl or on HTV. You might have a little issue with that little dot right there, but I think otherwise it should be okay. Now I do see a little flaw over here, so I'm just gonna go to contour and hide that little dot, hopefully. Let's see if I got rid of it. Nope. Sometimes those little dots can be tough to get rid of, and they're hard to find over here as well because there are so many other small little dots. So I just kind of try. If I can't get rid of it, I can also just use slice, but I got rid of it, so we're good. Now let's go ahead back to our upload, and I'm going to add this one to our canvas as well, and that way we can cut both of these together. But look at that. I think honestly it's pretty easy to do, and you can see this is my aunt's handwriting, my handwriting. You can see the difference though. She wrote with a ballpoint pen and I wrote with a Sharpie. So you can really see that mine doesn't have a lot of those little like slight imperfections like it is right here. But otherwise, I think they came out really good. Now you can put these on all sorts of things. You can use them with HTV, you can use them with permanent vinyl, you could even print and cut them if you wanted to. There's a lot of things that you can put them on, like ornaments, blankets, shirts. Honestly, the limits are endless with these, especially if you want to do something for like a memorial piece or something like that. They're really fun. I have done handwriting, my own handwriting on a anniversary gift for my husband that was really fun. So let's go ahead. We're going to click on make it. Let me just make sure these aren't like enormous. No, those are pretty good sizes. I'm going to go ahead and click make it. It's going to ask me to save. I will save, not save my project right now, but I will get to it later. And then you can see here that they're ready to go. Now I am going to just turn this one sideways and slide it up just to this point. That way I can only cut this part of my HD or my vinyl. We're going to do these on vinyl, but again, you can do them on HTV as well. You can make them as big or as small as you want, but this is just a great, simple, fun project that really is going to teach you some really cool skills. And I know this is something that a lot of people want to do. And you can do this with drawings as well. If your kid makes a drawing and you want to like put it on vinyl, you can do that by just simply scanning or taking a clear picture of it and uploading it just the way I've showed you here. Now, all we're going to do is go ahead and cut these out and I'll show you what they look like. We're just using some permanent vinyl, so I'm going to go ahead and load this in. We're going to let this cut, and then we can weed, and I'll show you what it looks like. Finished signatures. I think they look so cool. My Aunt Judy has such a fun signature because she gets a little happy face, but I love that you're able to capture such a cool moment with vinyl or HTV. And like I said, there's just a lot of ways to do this. You could take a picture with your phone, you could scan it,
have somebody write with a Sharpie to get it nice and thick, or you can take some from a already written signature and make that work as well. Now, there's definitely lots of ways to remove backgrounds, whether you're using Cricut Design Space, remove.bg, or about a million other programs that you can use to remove backgrounds. I'll list some of the ones that I've used and like down below. So if you struggle with the Cricut, you do have some other options to give a try for each of these. Because you saw how badly this one came out with remove.bg, but removing with Cricut actually did a really nice job. That's not always true, so I definitely think you need to try some different options and see which one gives you the cleanest design. Now, if you have any questions, please let me know in those comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure that you're subscribed here on YouTube. That way you don't miss out on any of the fun, crafty content we have coming. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting.